Quill hoped this was a shortcut to the castle. What she found was a strange and vibrant place, shrouded in perpetual twilight. But something about it was oddly familiar.
Infested.
A grumble echoed from the cave.
And why would I do that?
It croaked loudly, annoyed at either nothing or something.
You in there!
Declared Quill boldly.
Where are we? I'm looking for the fastest way to the castle.
Recognized the toad as Veda's steed from the mire. Seemingly oblivious to Quill, he continued.
Fine. I'll open the route. Give them your fancy test. But you're only digging yourself a deeper grave with Rootseer Veda.
If Veda knew I led you here, she'd burn my roots from existence.
A voice rose from the soil, gently shaking the branches.
But I need to know you can handle the perils of the castle.
Thank you.
No animal has ever crossed into a sprite's heartwood. The words radiated from the leaves. You must prove I've not erred in giving you the glass relic. Start, but we'll have more work to do if Vada is ever going to accept you as her champion. I'll summon you again when you're ready. Quill and the Reader were reunited with the Toad of Cantankerous Disposition.
One test. Small flies, if you ask me. I doubt they'll even find the second portal back.
Thank you.
Quill felt a swell of pride as she approached the Cavern River. Its guiding banks once led her people to safety after the Cinder Knight. Now, all these years later, she would follow it back. Quill's muscles ached, and her eyes grew heavy. She decided it best to set up camp and rest before journeying on to the castle.
Hey, kid. Good. You're alive.
The starling spoke as it circled the campfire. Quill gasped in shock as the starling unveiled monstrous wings and curled horns. It descended, talons gleaming.
Oh, dear. I didn't mean to scare you.
I'm not scared, Quill replied. I just didn't know starlings were feathered.
This starving thing's gotta go, kid. The name's Adurin. No, we aren't feathered. Only me. I'm working on it. Let's just say choosing the wrong friends comes with a price. But you seem like a good friend to have.
Thanks, I think. Quill readied her meal and paused to take in the strange winged creature who now called her friend. As a field of stars bloomed over the sky, their campfire conversations deepened.
He's all I have. If I lose him, I don't know what I'll do,
confided Quill. Adurin looked down at his wings.
If I help you find him, can you help me?
If we can, we will, Starling. I mean, Adurin.
Although Quill was far from the safety and comfort of her nook in the cottage, her exhaustion led her into a deep sleep.
Hey, Ghostface. A lot of folks have been waiting for a reader like you to return. I know I have. I'm going to scout the castle up ahead. Keep her safe, okay? For both our sakes.
Durin was nowhere to be found. But looming high on a distant bluff was the castle, a stark reminder of what mattered most. Quill drew a deep breath and readied herself for the journey ahead.
Upon their return, it was evident the Toad had not warmed to their company.
You really are asking for it. When they fail this second test, dibs on the runt for dinner.
He muttered to no one in particular. I've heard through my little buds that you've made great strides on your journey. The voice rang from the wood. But the true test of twofold requires mastery from you both. The Arcane are enraged by your bond. The stronger it becomes, the harder you'll be to defeat. Reader, through this sword, Quill can channel your energy. Thank you. Be steadfast with this one, Rita. Advise the voice. Things will get difficult. But you mustn't close the book on your hero.
Quill felt more assured, more ready for the dangers of the castle.
The toad, however, was not yet impressed.
Still just a rodent in champion's clothes, if you ask me. Doubt they'll find the last portal back here.